A lot of times when you build any kind of no-code solution, you are collecting information from people outside of the organization. For this, forms are perfect. And I'm really excited to announce that SmartSuite has put a lot of work into their forms. They continue to make new enhancements so that their forms are more and more powerful. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you all the key features of SmartSuite Forms, perfect for beginners, and we are going to go into all the details. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the most out of your no-code tools, and SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools. Now, as I mentioned, we are going to be diving into forms for SmartSuite, how you are going to collect information from people outside of your organization. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. I have put together this training to help you unpack no-code automation and start saving you tons of time. It doesn't matter what tool you use, whether it's SmartSuite or something else like Zapier or Make.com, automation all works the same in no-code. Grab that free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of things, and I'm going to dive into the form features inside of SmartSuite. Here I am inside of my solution called No Code Academy, and I've just built a new table for forms. Now, the first thing you need to understand about a SmartSuite form is that what it does when someone submits a SmartSuite form, it has one specific action. It will create a record in one table. So SmartSuite forms natively are not a good fit if you need to create records in multiple places. Right now, that functionality is not available. So when you're submitting a form, one record in one table. You can, of course, build automation to trigger off of that record creation. So for example, if you had some sort of a template where you submit an invoice, then you could create the line item records for that invoice in some sort of automation after the form is submitted. But the only thing a form can do, big takeaway, is create one record in one table. So here I am in this table, and all I have is the one field called record name. Well, technically I also have some comments, an auto number, a description, first created and last created. So the second key takeaway is that the only data that we can affect in a form that we can collect is information or fields where people can actually write information to it, write data to the field. So a field like an auto number, this is automatically generated by the system, and so nobody can actually write data to the auto number. Let me bring in these fields and show you exactly what I mean here. So if I create a new record by scratch without actually getting into the form, and I just name it name here, and of course I can add comments, but you'll notice that I don't actually get to set the auto number. See, the value of this is generated when I save the record. So let me click out of the record, and you'll see that just like that, the record just came into existence. It was created on July 18th, the date of this recording, by myself. It was last updated July 18th by me as well. And the auto number, this is number one. It's the first record in this table. Now, I can't affect any of these particular fields by writing data to them. So, of course, I can't use these fields in my form. Now, on the other hand, I can write to a description. So I could say new data here, right? In the description, new data here. And once I save that, now, of course, we will see that information in the record. So this is great. These are what we would call independent fields, meaning that we can actually write data to them. So it's very, very important to understand that your independent fields inside of SmartSuite are the only ones that you can include in your forms. So what this means is if you have lookup fields, if you have formula fields, these types of fields are dependent. They calculate their output and they depend on other fields and other data for their output. So those fields will not be available in a form because you're not writing data directly to them. Now that we understand that, any different fields where we can write data to, so things like text, text area, numbers, percent, you know, currency, these are all available inside of our form. So let's actually drop in a single select. I'll give us option 1 and option 2, and we'll go ahead and add this field. And we also have this large text area for our description, and we just have a single line text for our record name. Now, in order to create a form inside of SmartSuite, we're going to go to the bottom left corner, and we can say Create View, and you see it right here. Or if we bring up this, we have to scroll down to the bottom to see that form, and we can name the form whatever we'd like, choose whether it's going to be public or private, and then create the view. Now here, we have a lot of options, and this is what I love about the new SmartSuite features that we're going to get into. But before we get to the different display elements, let's see our different fields. These are the independent fields that we have in our SmartSuite table. We have the record name. I can add that in. Pops in right here. We have description. That was the text area. Pops in right here. And we have our single select. We have no default value set up right here. And of course, we could establish a default value if we wanted to. So we can add and subtract the different fields in our table and put them into the form. So if I didn't want to ask for a description, if I remove it from the form, we haven't removed it from the table. It's just not being collected when people submit the form. We also have the option to make any of these fields required that we would like. And beyond that, we can also set some conditions. So if we wanted to only show this particular element on our form after we had information in the record name, for example, we could do that. We could say only show this conditionally. And then we can set up those conditions. So we would say we only want to show the single select when the record name is not empty. So now only after the record name has information in it do we see the next question on the form. So this is how the conditional logic works inside of a SmartSuite form. What is not possible yet is writing to multiple different form pages. So right now we just have the one form page, and you can conditionally make the different elements on the form available depending on the action that's been taken previously in the form. Now we've got to talk about the amazing new features that SmartSuite has released, because now forms are becoming even more powerful because you can just add so many cool elements. I'm talking about these display elements right here. So number one, I've got my logo up here at the top. I can change this or I can keep it to show SmartSuite logo. And here are my display elements. I can bring in this new element of a video. Check this out. When I select this, this is a static element where I'm putting in a particular URL. So right here, SmartSuite has set it up by default to be the About SmartSuite video on YouTube. And we can set the max height. We can change this to make it very small. I don't know why we would do that. And so you have full control over how this video is going to show up. Now, in addition, we can still set conditions here. So we could say only after they have made a selection from the single select. So if single select is not empty once they've made a selection, then and only then are we going to show this video. So this is really neat, right? I can't think of many other tools where we can just embed a video right in the form. This can really help with instruction or some sort of tutorial as people are filling out information in your form. Now we also have this new image here. So by default, we have this particular image, but we can click here to update it and just drop in a static image that we want to have show up in our form every time. We can also choose how it's going to show up and what the height is. So if we want it to be a banner like this, we can do so. And of course, we can also reorder this in our form. We can put it wherever we'd like by clicking and dragging it about. So right here, if we hover over, we got to get it just right. You'll see that it has those dots that appear right to the left of my cursor. If I grab it, I can reorder everything on my form so I can put this banner up here at the top. Now we also have the form title. I'll say form here, and we can also add a description, description here. And in addition, we have the ability to add dividers. I really like this feature. I'll drop this little divider down here at the bottom, but then also move it up. And you can see that with the divider, if we click in, we can actually add a label, which is going to show up in the middle of the divider. So text here is what I'll show in this example. And we can customize the color as well. Let's use this nice blue. So we're going to get this divider to show up like this. When we're actually in the form itself, we're not going to see the element name. So don't worry about that. We're going to preview this after we're done setting up our form, and you can see all the different components. And one other piece that I really like is bringing in the callout. So the callout gives us the ability to actually emphasize some text here. So we can do it with info, note, success, warning. So we could display this warning, for example, that says, Let's say we want to set up a condition where if somebody picks the single select and they select option two, we want to say this is an odd option. So now we've set up some conditional logic for a callout that you can see, right? We've said, hey, under the condition that somebody selects option two, then we're going to bring out this callout that says this is a strange option. Now, let's see this in action. We've got all these different elements. The first thing we need to do is actually say, share the form. If this is not highlighted, as it is now yellow, then the form has not yet been shared. This is a mistake that I tend to make a lot. So make sure that once you've built your form, you then share it. And now we can share this URL or use this embed code to embed this on a website. So let's go ahead and actually preview the form. And right here, we'll just pop this up in the same window. And it doesn't look like much yet because we've set up all of our conditional logic. So we can set up a record name. So I'll say name. And you'll notice that conditionally, our single select shows up now. And you can see the nice little divider we set up as well as the banner image. And I can make a selection. If I make selection option one, well, now we've met the condition that we set forth to show this video. And now the person could submit and or watch the video right in this window just by clicking play. And then also, if we select option two, then we get this little call out that says, this is a strange option. Well, when we submit this information, what happens? Well, we go to our success page, but also just as importantly, or maybe more importantly, we've collected this data. It's immediately integrated with SmartSuite. We don't need to build any mapping or anything fancy. This is taking the information that's sent right from the form and sending it right here. Now you'll notice that we put in a name, that we put in option two, and then our dependent fields, the things like the auto number, first created and last updated, this is gonna show the date and time and the next number in the sequence, etc. So those pieces will still calculate as normal. Hey, I know we went pretty quick in this video. Any questions you have about SmartSuite Forms, swing by our website. We are here to help. And of course, if you got value from this video, please give us a thumbs up so that we can continue doing what we do. That's it for this one. In the meantime, keep on building.